managing devices at scale over the year when they're connected to different types of backend might not always be easy. The Mender is a solution that allows you to do exactly that. Deploy software over the year and manage your devices. And today, Einstein from Mender is here to tell us about an integration with the Azure IoT Hub from Mender that allows to seamlessly create identities and establish connectivity between devices and IoT Hub, all of that in Mender. So that's today on the IoT Show. You're watching the IoT Show. I'm Olivier, your host, and today we're going to talk about Mender. And for that, we have Einstein here. Einstein, how are you?
Good. Thanks for having me.
Well, before we jump into the topic of the day, which is about managing devices and integrating, connecting these devices to manage through Mender to Azure IoT Hub, I would like for you to give us a short introduction about yourself. You came to the IoT Show some time ago, a year and a half ago. To introduce Mender, but I think it's been long enough so that we have you again on the show. So tell us a bit about yourself. Tell us about Mender real quick.
Sure. It's good to be back. So Mender is an over-the-air software update manager and device management solution with advanced features, and it's backed by an open source community. So I am the CTO of the company, and I basically lead the product development.
Okay, perfect. So we have the right person to talk technical here. That's perfect. So you do have customers using Mender, and you just mentioned it's about over-the-air updates. This is a very critical point of IoT, managing your devices, making sure they're up to date so that you patch them with security patches and you get the latest version of softwares and so on. And tell us a bit about what kind of customers you have, what kind of solutions they are building, and how they are using and leveraging Mender in their solutions.
Definitely. So it's quite interesting to work in the IoT space because it's such a big variety. So I would say there's no specific vertical that is bigger than the others. But some examples we have is Airbus, for example, to update devices that are in the plane. And this is a very interesting environment because you can only update them while the plane is taxiing. So you cannot do it while it's flying, obviously. And then we have other vertical within energy, Valent, for example, heating systems for homes. That's another example. So they live in very diverse environments. Some are offline pretty much all the time, and others are connected at all times.
And if I were to ask you, what's specific and special about Mender? There are other solutions for managing devices remotely. What makes Mender special?
Right. So we have an end-to-end solution. So we develop both the client and the server. So we deliver both as end-to-end solution. And we have focused only on OTA and device management. So we have some advanced features in that respect. And it's also open source. The core with a community behind it.
Okay. So deploying devices, managing them remotely in terms of software update is one thing. The other one, and we're big there, which is connecting these devices to a cloud solution, a cloud application. So you guys are in the business of this management of devices. But customers, they don't like to have two solutions. So it's better if they integrate. And as a matter of fact, you guys put together some level of integration with Azure IoT. Tell me a bit about that integration. And I know for a fact you came with demos. And so, tell us a bit about that integration and how it works.
Absolutely. So we're seeing a growth in Azure usage among our customer base as well. And we're seeing they're using Azure to get telemetry and connect their application. And they're using Mender to develop or to manage and update their devices. So it gets a bit complicated for them to manage all of this on their own. So we wanted to see how can we simplify this. So what we're doing is that we allow Mender to manage the devices in Azure. So you kind of have one place where you can provision and manage your devices.
Okay, that makes sense because device identity is something that's very key. But yes, as soon as you start having different identities for the same device in different systems, it can get really quick, complicated, and well, depending on how many devices you have connected, you know, it could be a headache. So let's look at that. Let's look at what the integration looks like and how a customer using Mender or someone using Mender today can connect their devices easily to Azure IoT Hub.
Absolutely. So the first thing I wanted to show you is that I have an environment here. I have an Azure IoT Hub, and then I have the Mender server. I would first head over to the settings when I'm starting out, go to integrations. As you can see, I've already connected my Mender server to the Azure IoT Hub that I have. Now that I've done this, Mender will automatically create devices in Azure IoT Hub. So I can show an example of this. I have a new device in Mender. I will simply accept it here. And you could see, let me see if I find it under accepted. And you can see the device ID here in Mender A729 something. And now if I go to my IoT Hub, you can see that the device is here and enabled.
Nice. Nice. And it's using the same identity. Actually, you don't have to care about what identity it's using because Mender took control of that and created that new device ID in IoT Hub, mimicking what he had in the Mender database, right?
Exactly. So it used the same identity in Azure IoT that Mender is using. So it's easy to correlate those two devices.
Nice. So that's the first step, right? Really creating that identity, I guess, and we'll see that certainly later on. But there's a notion of device lifecycle, right? Devices, identities are created in the system, but then one day if the device is being retired or replaced, you need to manage that identity lifecycle basically and remove it from your systems.
Exactly. So this is a challenge over time, obviously. And Mender is also taking care of this. So you can see, we call it reject in Mender. So if we reject the device in Mender, you would see it under rejected there, but I'll just show any. And if I now go and refresh my IoT Hub, you can see that the status is disabled, which is the same as rejected in Azure
taxonomy. Yeah. Which means the device will not have access to the IoT Hub anymore. It's going to be denied access because the credentials are not working anymore.
Correct. Yeah, exactly. Okay. And the same would be true if I were to delete the device from Mender, it will also be deleted from the IoT Hub.
Nice. Love it. So Mender is used to configure devices as well, right? And so what we just saw here is Mender interacting with the IoT Hub service. What we didn't see here, but I guess it happens, is that when Mender creates the identity, it then retrieves the credentials for that device and then passes it down to the device itself for the device to be able to then connect to IoT Hub, right?
Exactly. So if we take it one step further, we can see that the connection string for the device itself is actually retrieved, just like you said, into Mender. And we can use the remote terminal in Mender to take a look at the device. And if you look inside this, there's a specific configuration file that Mender writes. All the configuration settings that you set in Mender. And here you can see the connection string for the device. So now the device
thing I wanted to just like, sorry for the interruptions here, but that's something which is very nice in Mender. You just like, you know, seamlessly brought up the terminal here, but here we're opening an SSH session from a browser into a device without knowing the IP address or whatnot of that device, because Mender establishes a communication tunnel. Is that what's going on here?
Yeah, exactly. So it's not using the SSH technology, but it's using WebSockets. It is a secure channel from the device to the Mender server. And it's only doing outbound connectivity here, so it does not require any open ports on the device.
Nice. Very nice. Sorry, I just wanted to bring that up because that's something that lots of our customers might find super useful, being able to interact with the OS on that device from a remote terminal that is all secured and taken care of for you.
Exactly. Yeah, you never know when you need it. If you plan things well, You hopefully won't need it, but usually you will need
it. That's why it's called troubleshooting here, right?
Exactly.
So yeah, so you did get this connection string for the device. Well, Mender did get it, and now you're showing us on the device what's going on.
Right. So now the connection string is available on the device. So if I had an Azure IoT application, I could simply read this connection string and immediately start sending data to Azure IoT.
Nice.
And I do actually have a demo application here I could show as well.
Okay.
And this is based on examples created by Microsoft. It's a very, very simple application. It sends telemetry in an infinite loop here. And you can see that it sends it at the frequency that's set by this variable telemetry send interval.
Okay.
And it reads also the device twin from Azure IoT Hub. And it sets this variable based on send interval from the device twin. And then it reports back also send interval so that we can see from the backend that it actually has configured the application.
Nice. And so you're saying, so here, interestingly, so the use of telemetry in twins is something very common in the Azure IoT world, right? So here you're going to run this application. What's going to be interesting, though, is that your customers are managing their device's configuration from Mender, right? So they're not just provisioning, they're also setting up the configuration for things like the, you know, at what pace the telemetry should be sent to a cloud service, right?
Exactly. So we do have an integration for this here as well to configure the device twin, and I will get into that. I just wanted to show first what you would do next is probably to deploy this application. So I have packaged it as a Mender artifact here. It's a single file. It's just one Python application. And it includes also a script to start it and pass the connection string from that file. So once I've created the artifact, as we call it, that contains the Python file, I can deploy this application to the device. There's some more advanced configuration. I won't use any of this right now, but you can schedule it and you can gradually roll out the application to the fleet. And you can also synchronize it so you can make sure that all devices are updated or none of them are, and retry if there are any failures. But I'll skip all that now. So I'll simply just create deployment with this Python application that's Azure enabled. And as you can see, it's finished already. Now, if I go back to my terminal, you can see it's been deployed here in a directory, and there is a log file. This is simply the application output log, and we can take a look at it. And as we expect, it started sending telemetry to Azure IoT.
Well done. Well done. That's super interesting because you started from a device that only was running, well, some sort of OS here, plus your client, the client from Mender. I would assume it was pre-provisioned with credentials to access Mender, right? Got authorized to connect to Mender. And then Mender did create the IoT Hub identity, retrieve the credentials, send them down to the device. And then, you did configure a deployment of an application that was using these credentials. And so you were able to deploy the package and then have, so basically you start from a device that is almost blank, only have the Mender client, and then you end up with something that is sending telemetry to Azure IoT. That's pretty, without touching it.
Exactly. Okay. And as you touched upon earlier as well, you can, we also integrated with the device twin in Azure, so we can edit this device's device twin. And as you might remember from our application, there was a device twin property called send interval that the application was reading. So I'll simply change that to 5 for the sake of this demo. And if we look back at, if we look back at the application output, you can see now that it did receive the new send interval, and it reported it back also to Azure IoT.
Brilliant. Pretty straightforward. Love it. That's definitely a great demo here. But there's one more thing that Mender does as well. It allows you to monitor devices, right? So you're able to get some level of information about errors that are going on that are proper to Mender.
Exactly. So in this case, what I wanted to monitor is the connectivity to Azure IoT Hub. So I will paste in two commands here in the terminal, and I can explain them very quickly. So what this does is tells Mender to create an alert if the word transport underscore exception is found in the application log file that we were just looking at. And this is a bit application dependent, what kind of errors, but you can customize it here. What I wanted to do is to actually try to trigger an error. So if I find my device in here, let me see if I remember the ID of it first. A7 something. All right, it's in here. So what I'll do here, I'll simply disable the device in Azure IoT Hub. And that should definitely cause some trouble for our application that depends on sending data to Azure IoT. So if we go back to the Mender interface, there is an option to filter devices that require attention. And you can see here that there is one, the one we have actually has an issue. And we can scroll down and we can see that this alert has now been triggered. We can look into it and you can see the matching line here that we were looking for. So it contains transport exceptions. And you can also see the lines leading up to it in our application log. So you can see the full exception here to help you get some more context of what happened, as well as the following lines as well.
Awesome. So like the full monitoring definitely integrated as well. I was just thinking about an interesting scenario here, you know, which is when you have devices that are different types and connected to different backend systems, right? You might not all send to a single IoT hub or a single cloud, actually. And so you can still manage from Mender all these devices in one place in terms both of configuration, deployment of apps, and logging, while these devices eventually talk to different backends and different applications. And everything is monitored here in Mender, right? That's one of the valid scenarios, I would guess.
Exactly. So a lot of things can go wrong when you connect to different systems, and you definitely want to have a way to make sure that you catch these kind of issues.
Awesome. Actually, that's great. And I love this integration. I love the way you guys have simplified that connectivity for your customers and our joint customers, hopefully. So if you want to learn more about what's going on with Mender, its integration with Azure IoT, you can go and check out this link below here, aka.ms/IoTshow/Mender.io or Mender.io. Einstein, thanks a lot for coming to the show. Have a great one. Everyone, thanks as well for joining. See you.